Harvey, welcome back. Once again, Capdozio, welcome to Imperator Rome. This is a brand new release from Paradox. I've been playing it for a little bit, a few hours here and there, just to see how things work, just trying to get my head around the game. So we're going to start and let's have a look, see how well we do on this. Now, obviously, this is, like I said, the latest game for Paradox. It comes based in the Romano period, which is a period I spent an awful lot of time studying. So, interesting for me, at least. And we're going to check it out. Let's have a look. So, I'm in an island about where to start, and I was thinking about starting up here, which we could do. Something like the Arsenio, the Gantians. Yeah, we could start somewhere down here. Could even start as one of the Deniers. The Gothonics. Start as German, maybe. Even as far as... Whoa, what the hell was that? Or even as far as India. I was thinking about maybe starting down here. As possibly Sparta. Which could be quite fun. Yeah, I think we'll start down here as Sparta. We'll see how well we go from here. So in Babylon 80 years ago, the Agrid King Alexander died suddenly at the age of 32 in the 5 years preceding his death. His continuing military successes had reshaped the world as known to the Greeks. His empire stretching uninterrupted from Egypt to the Indus. The shock of Alexander's early death and his lack of a chosen successor sent shockwaves through the hierarchy of satraps and generals who attended him, splintered the empire into elements ruled by these potentates. Styled as the Diarchy for many years, they and their successors have been locked in bitter struggle over the future of the empire, drawing all nations within their sphere of influence into the conflict. The wars of the Diarchy will surely continue, and perhaps it is up to Sparta to decide how they will end. So here we are. So we have a Dislord character in the form of this guy. Clemius Agaid. Right. That's me. So who have we got who is unhappy? The Papliad family. There we go. I'll shut them up. My ruler is unmarried. So, wish to arrange a nice marriage. I am an Agaid. So, let's have a look what we've got here. Abrasive? Yes, she'll do. There we go. Right, given that we're Sparta, we're going to go as much military as we can. So military tech investment, yep. And I think we'll take the herbalism one. Bit of extra tech speed in there. Okay, so lots of people are following our guy. We are currently losing, we're on the verge of losing a bit of cash here. So, first thing we're going to do is we're going to fabricate a claim on Laconia. And we're just going to go good old fashioned Spartan war machine here. Okay, just unpause a little bit. So now we need trade routes. We could really do with someone being willing to trade with us. We are Spartans. This is what we do. Now I'm going for Messenia, because that's pretty much... Messenian helots were basically Spartan slaves for a long ass time. So, yeah. Now then, have Messenia managed to get an ally with anybody? Let's have a look. Messenia. No, they haven't. Good. We need to find an import. Trade route. No one wants to sell his elephants. Iron. Stone. None. No one. So in Sparta we're producing iron, grain, veg, and wine. That's... yep. We're producing everywhere. We do have a surplus of grain. Which is a good thing. Right. The other thing we need to do. Traditions. There we go, so we just need to save up a lot of that for the traditions. There we go, we go straight for Messenia. Which, like I said, is pretty accurate. Got my first Statigos. Should be carrying a spear, he's a Spartan. Spartans carried spears. In fact, most Greeks did, to be honest. Okay, so they have three regiments. And they're all down there. In Mothone. So. Okay. There we go. One down. He's about to get squished. Can't go down to Mathon. Damn it. Never mind. Spawns are actually really interesting people, but they were a bit weird. To say the least. Okay. Peloponnesian. Defensive League with Missin. Well, that's a bit late. Lapron coming in, but that's a bit late, boys. Can I actually get up here? No, not yet. Okay, 7,000 troops in. I have 10,000. Pretty soon they won't be able to hold that. But yeah, Messenia basically became, they were... It's a weird system. They were effectively tributaries of Sparta, but not in the same sense. Helots basically were slaves, the people of Messenia. The Spartans would basically take them as slaves. And every year they'd declare war on them again just to keep it all nice and legal so they could go and slaughter as many people as they wanted. A young rascal by the Democratic approached Basilius in private this morning. Husband spoke of vision of new futures. She was found by her loved ones having been burnt at the stake. We now take the oratory power. I think we'll take the cash to begin with. But yeah, so, and the Spartans had the best of the youngsters coming through the Agoge were sent to basically groups where they would go and hunt down, the special group where they would go and hunt down any troublemakers in Messenia. So this is pretty historically accurate. And obviously you didn't want to mess around with the Spartans. The Aetites were an incredible fighting force. It's one thing they were very good at. Corinthos. So yeah. Sparta's system as well, very odd, very unique. Their entire system was about making sure that nothing ever changed. For example, different levels of government. They had two kings at any given time. Each one was, the idea was each one reported to the other. Very weird, but hey, it worked for them. But yeah. And as soon as anyone had finished on the government with the different levels of it, one was an elected body, as soon as you finished on that, your first duty was to be put on trial for your life, and if you were found guilty of doing anything that would damage Sparta, you were executed. So yeah, the idea was don't mess about and don't do anything that will mess up the Spartan system. A lot of people think, yeah, well, obviously they've watched things like the 300 and think, oh, I know what it's about. No, you don't. Okay, so these guys now have no... That's quite cool. Okay, Malav Army's additional. Yeah, I think we'll take that. That'd be very handy. Don't know where that Messenian army ran off to. Monthly loyalty, monthly corruption. He's arbitrary. I don't like him. Oh, we've got another fight going on over here. What we got here? Troyzen versus Argos. Argos, the shit stirrer of the Peloponnesian League. Okay. Trade with, is there anybody willing to trade? Yeah. I don't think we need manpower at the moment. What we need is more money. Wine, dates. Yeah, glass. Spin glass in for Macedonia. That'd be nice. We're losing the whole duck in a month, but hopefully we'll sort that out. It is duck insufficient. Well, gold, bags of money, whatever the hell they are in this one. But pretty soon, this will fall, and Messeni will become ours. Messene. Province. Olives. Fish. And wine. Current ruler. There we go. Like I said, Sparta really had two kings at any given time. They acted as generals, rulers, and priests. So yeah, an awful lot under one hat. Bye, Tricia. Bye, Trish. The president comes not from without, but from within. A constant infighting between those who would know themselves there can consume countless lives. Comenius. Well, he is the guy who is, he's the guy who is trying to, lead a revolt against me. So my son is not yet ready. There's plenty of supporters, which is good. His loyalty's good, his loyalty's not bad, his is abysmal. But hey, there you go. So we're losing less money now, which is good news for us. Is that the Messenian troops coming around? That's Anatolia. Considering he's been spending increasing quantities of time with another petty claimant to our throne. The two are natural enemies, so I might be particularly careful with this developing situation. Thanks to the squeaky face of the conspirators, we were able to determine that they were having an animated discussion about Ficus Firecleared, another petty claimant. Warn him. Are you guys involved in my war? Yes, you are. There we go. There we go. So now, Sparta be big. Now we're only losing half a ducat a month now. So now we just need to expand just a little bit more. Klaus Eger chose to make the plan to move against Fasus Vile clear today, and apparently overconfident his own abilities. Unfortunately, due to poor martial abilities, that went in favour of the attacker, although the defender managed to escape, having only been wounded. Bravo. Right. So. Now, what we need to do is create a new unit. I'm going to grab one of these. Another one of these. Select this unit. And we're going to disband them. We have what we needed. We have our Messenian helots underneath us. We can be quite happy with that. Now, who are you allied with? Heraglia. Oh, Heraglia. Oh, right next door. Yeah. Okay, so we can't form an alliance with them. Never mind. Argos is getting his ass handed to it. Never mind. There we go. We're making a little bit of money now. That's where we need to be. No deficit. Okay, so let's get some more of that. Tech. Just need 100 more to finish that off. Religion. We're still working on the discipline here. Commerce fine. Tributes. We're not getting any. That's fine. Wages are fine. Our maintenance is fine. Everything's fine. We're Sparta. We don't need boats. What sort of plum would want us with boats? These are all the mercs that we can recruit. Okay, why would we need to? We're Spartans! Okay, so that's the Greek region. Provincial. This is what we want, so we want to just move eventually up as far as places like Olympios, Elis. Who are these guys allied with on the way through? Elis and Angion. Interesting. I will go for Proxenioi. Good. Keep people a bit happy about others. We don't want to upset too many people here if we can. So we're just sitting back now. Oh. Argos. Argos. A subject country. They're a subject. Okay, so they're a subject of... Okay. So how far down do your... How many... Who do you have under you? Argos, Euboea, Pannonia, guaranteed countries, Seleucia and Egypt. Militaries allowed access, so, but really, so you have Argos who's about to be eaten, Euboea and Pannonia. Okay, this makes things a little bit more interesting for me. Where is our barbarian power, diplomacy, unrest and disloyalty, opinion, region, fortifications, players, trade routes, no, terrain, no, political, culture, religion, no, provinces, no, 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 it's got to be that, there we go, right. So people don't mind us too much, a little bit of aggressive expansion, which we'll soon get rid of. Yes, Elis, Boeotia, and Angrion. Angrion up there, I'm not... They take a while to get involved here. You, on the other hand. Just two little ones. That could be an interesting assault there. Egyptian ship. Ugh. Local unrest. That's right. That we can handle. They've got a defensive lead going down here already. Oh god. Where's that get? Oh, blimey. Grikia. Troizen. Troizen and Epidaurus. That's fine. Right. Now we're in a defensive league with Troizen. And Epidaurus, which are these horse guys. Cool, so that keeps them out of my hair for the minute. So that's these two. at war with quite a few people here. Okay, so once more, the renowned Olympic Games are due to occur in the city of Olympia. The traditions surrounding these games are ancient, repeated dating back to the days of the mighty Heracles himself, the occasion which all of Greece rejoices. It's our custom to send the proudest, most noble sons of Sparta to compete on our behalf. We've found two ideal candidates, a well-muscled brute of a man by the name of Demacrius, and a well-muscled brute of a man who calls himself Patroclus. But if we take a look, this guy is generally the better out of the pair, so Patroclus. There we go. Right. Researcher needed. Cool. So his loyalty is good, his popularity is okay. He has no real prominence. Yep, he'll do. Not bothered. Okay, so we're making 0.47. There we go. Let's get two more of these. No. No one else is coming through. Okay, so what I'm going to do is move through here. And possibly here as well. Okay. That's fine, you do that, I'll come for you. I'm not worried. Sparta is growing. There we go. Okay, so here we go, just can't imagine it anymore. It seems to be getting far too real. Interesting. I'm now stressed. I'm disciplined, I'm in mourning, which doesn't help. I'm stressed. Decline. Ellis. Yes. That's fine. This is brilliant because these guys are also allied with Ellis. They're not. No, they're not. Who were Ellis allied with that I didn't want them to be? This is fine. Okay. So next. Now we just need to open up a little bit. This alliance with Ellis. There it is. So this alliance with Ellis is only temporary. It's basically just so I can attack here with my back covered. Maybe 200. Oh well, my league's gone. Never mind. There we go. So now, Trojan, let's see where you go now. We need to get more oratory power. Can't afford it at the moment. Never mind. And to be fair, we could just go for no CB, best CB. My stability will be reduced by 2. That I really don't want to do. Yeah, we require a lot of religious points in order to get that up. Symphalia. There we go, people are starting to pay tribute to me, which is nice. Keep doing that, guys. Keep doing that. Argos is occupied by treason. This is interesting. Right. You're at war with Azania. There's a lot of wars going on here. This is good for me. Because, as the one with the most troops, it gives me a chance to stand around an eyeball for a minute. I can watch what people are doing. No one wants to buy my wine. No one wants to buy my grain. Never mind. I'll tweet some nervousness and smoke in the court. The whispers began to the players finally reached the ear of the Basileus. It seems that someone has been spreading rumours and spinning yarns of his unequal profligacy and unfitness for the throne. Damage is done, but... Vengeful. Extra finesse, loose charisma, can... Ooh! Effective full at assassinate cost. Who's a disloyal character? Veterans, that's good if we wish to do that, which we may need to at some point soon, but not at this very moment. Military are doing alright at the moment. Could need some of these traditions. Yeah, that'll be that. The traitor snake who attempted to demean the name of Avis has been identified as none other who confessed quickly to his crimes. Pardon him, his lesson is learned. Vengeful stress and morning disciplined. There we go. But still doing alright. No. Chosen has already lost that particular position. No. I don't want a Kaya. There is a big ass war going on here. Good, you're not involved in it either, are you? No. It gives me the perfect opportunity to strike in a minute. So. Well, yeah, we're fine on money for the minute. There we go with our spear. That looks a bit better. Should be wearing a red war cloak. We are Spartans after all. Hellenistic Peloponnesian. But yeah, Messenia basically, Sparta itself with its ring of mountains around it basically didn't have a wall because it didn't really need it. There we go, look at this, more fighting going on up there. Lots of battles going on. What can we do with more oratory power? Another little scrap going on, there we go. Shame there's no drill button. Build a road. Cool, we've got more babbies. We have more babbies, it's what we wanted. Yeah. Alice is now in our defensive league. One, two, three. Although this league is only temporary. I don't plan on holding it for long. Standard measures, national tax. Yep, let's grab that, national tax. So we should tick up a little bit here. Yep. Which is good news. Go for more heavy infantry. Which is what we need. Okay, but anyway, I'm going to leave that there. So we're just going to pause this at the end of the month. We just need to save up our religion as well to get another blessing. 29th and done. There we go. 1st of February, 4:55. So yeah, we'll leave that there. But yeah, so this is Imperator. I hope you enjoy this. Yeah, we'll see how far we get. The aim obviously would be to unite. What decisions can we make here? Decisions, important decisions. Adopt Arcadia. Reunite Imperial Ambition. Form Arcadia. So yeah, basically for Arcadia, we need all of that lot, which we could do. But anyway, so we'll leave that there. But again, thank you for your time. And for the minute, I've been Cappadocia. Signing off.